Imagine a jet that can take off and land like a helicopter. It flies faster than many conventional fighters. The Harrier was that jet, and its legacy still shapes aviation today. But why hasn't the UK ever made another one? Stick around, because the story behind the end of the Harrier program is more surprising than you might think. The Harrier Jet, a revolutionary leap in aviation history. The Harrier Jump Jet was one of the most groundbreaking advancements in aviation. When it was first introduced in the 1960s, it had the capability to take off and land vertically, a feature that made it a game changer for the military. This iconic feature was perfect for aircraft carriers, where space was limited, and it allowed the UK to use a more versatile fleet. But what made the Harrier such a success at first became a difficult challenge to replicate when the UK considered building another one. The end of an era, the closing of the British Aerospace Harrier program. Fast forward to the 1990s, and the UK's Harrier production program was winding down. The Harrier GR5, a significant upgrade to the original design, was the last model produced in significant numbers. Why didn't the UK push forward with new iterations? British Aerospace, the company behind the Harrier's development, faced financial struggles, which made it difficult to justify investing in the development of a new generation of Harrier jets. The end of the British Aerospace Harrier program meant the country lost the capacity to develop a successor independently. The UK's focus shifted, emphasis on Eurofighter and other fighters. By the time the Harrier's design had reached its limitations, the UK military was looking towards newer, more advanced fighter aircraft. The Eurofighter Typhoon was seen as a more versatile and powerful multi-role aircraft, offering supersonic speed, enhanced weaponry, and greater operational capabilities. While the Harrier was excellent for short takeoff and vertical landing missions, the UK's defense priorities had shifted toward conventional, faster, and more capable jets. The Typhoon represented a broader vision for future air combat, and with multinational partnerships, it was a higher priority than renewing the Harrier. The shift to the Joint Strike Fighter, the F-35's dominance. In the early 2000s, the UK joined the US-led F-35 Joint Strike Fighter program. The decision to participate in this multinational project marked a strategic pivot for the UK's air capabilities. The F-35 was designed to offer a supersonic stealth fighter that could perform short takeoff and vertical landing operations, essentially combining the best features of the Harrier with cutting-edge technology. The decision to abandon the development of a new Harrier and instead focus on the F-35 was driven by its potential for versatility, advanced stealth features, and higher performance. The F-35 was to be the next generation aircraft for the UK, leaving the Harrier's legacy behind. Cost overruns and budget constraints. Let's be real, building a fighter jet is expensive, and the cost of developing a new Harrier jet was an obstacle the UK simply couldn't overcome. With military budgets tightening and defense spending constantly scrutinized, the UK government opted to invest in a shared international project with the US, which would significantly reduce costs. The F-35, with its international development and production costs spread across multiple countries, was a far more financially viable option than designing a new Harrier from scratch. The economics of military spending made it clear that a single nation effort for a Harrier successor wasn't practical. Technological advancements. The need for a modernized approach. By the time the 21st century rolled around, technology had evolved beyond the Harrier's original capabilities. The advent of modern radar, avionics, and weapon systems meant that the military wanted more advanced jets capable of outclassing older designs. The Harrier, despite its historical significance, was now an older aircraft with outdated technology. Trying to develop another Harrier would require overcoming technological hurdles that could only be achieved through a complete redesign, something that might have made it harder to compete with the sheer power and capabilities of other modern jets, like the F-35. Changing military needs. A move toward multi-role fighters. Military strategy had also shifted. The focus was now on multi-role aircraft that could handle a variety of missions, from air superiority to ground attack to intelligence gathering. While the Harrier was exceptional for ground support and close air support, it lacked the versatility needed for the full range of modern air combat roles. Multi-role jets like the Typhoon and F-35 were designed to do it all: air dominance, precision strikes, and everything in between. The UK's defense strategy moved towards maximizing the capabilities of fewer, more adaptable jets, rather than maintaining a niche aircraft like the Harrier. The global shift in naval aviation. Naval aviation underwent a major shift in the 1990s and early 2000s. The Harrier had been vital to the Royal Navy, but with advances in aircraft carrier design and more powerful conventional aircraft, the need for a jet that could take off and land vertically became less urgent. Larger carriers could accommodate jets with longer takeoff runs, and conventional fighter jets became more common in naval operations. The Royal Navy and other countries around the world started to focus on carrier-based aircraft like the F-18 Hornet, and later, the F-35B, which was a joint solution with the U.S. The shift away from short takeoff and vertical landing aircraft, along with the rise of larger and more capable carriers, made it clear that the Harrier's time had passed. The influence of the U.S., the Transatlantic Partnership, the U.K.'s decision to rely on the U.S. for its next-generation fighter aircraft, was largely driven by transatlantic relations and defense partnerships. The U.S. military was already investing heavily in the development of the F-35, and the U.K.'s participation in the program was a natural choice. The strategic importance of the U.S.-UK defense relationship meant that the U.K. was more inclined to invest in a fighter jet that would work in harmony with the U.S. military's needs. The Harrier, though a symbol of British innovation, was a lone wolf in an increasingly cooperative international military ecosystem, where joint development and collaboration were the future. Legacy of the Harrier, why it will always be remembered. Despite the UK never making another Harrier jet, the legacy of the Harrier lives on. The Harrier will forever be remembered as one of the most remarkable aircraft in aviation history. It set the standard for short takeoff and vertical landing jets, influencing generations of aircraft, including the F-35B. Even though the UK turned its attention to other aircraft like the Eurofighter and F-35, the Harrier continues to serve in other countries like India and the United States, with the F-35B even paying homage to the Harrier's vertical takeoff and landing capabilities. The Harrier may not have had a direct successor in the UK, but it laid the groundwork for future developments in naval aviation and military technology. The Harrier legacy, the jet that changed the skies forever. The UK may never have made another Harrier, but its impact on aviation remains undeniable. The Harrier, a revolutionary jet capable of vertical takeoff and landing, was the game-changer of its time, allowing military forces to operate in ways that were previously unimaginable. It was the first aircraft that could be used on small, unconventional landing areas like aircraft carriers, remote airstrips, and even forward operating bases. The Harrier's unique capabilities made it a symbol of British ingenuity and a key asset for the Royal Navy, who used it for decades to protect the seas. While the world has moved on to faster, more advanced jets like the F-35, the Harrier's legacy lives on in its influence on modern vertical takeoff and landing technology. Its design and operational principles were the blueprint for the next generation of multi-role stealthy aircraft. The jet's flexibility, ruggedness, and adaptability paved the way for the versatile F-35B, which continues to honor the Harrier's spirit. Today, the Harrier may no longer be in service, but its influence on aviation design, military strategy, and the very concept of carrier-based operations remains a lasting legacy. The Harrier is a reminder of how a single aircraft can change the course of aviation history, proving that innovation often knows no bounds. That's all for today's video. If you enjoyed this deep dive into the legacy of the Harrier jet, make sure to hit that like button and subscribe for more fascinating insights. Don't forget to share this video with your friends and leave a comment below with your thoughts on the Harrier's impact. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next one.